Hi, I'm Nuan from AWS.
Hi, I'm Mike Schultz from Age of Learning, and this is my architecture.
Mike, tell us about Age of Learning.
Yeah, Age of Learning is the leading education technology innovator in creating engaging and effective resources to help children achieve academic success.
Tell us about the problem that you're solving with this architecture.
Yeah, so previously we had a just host of about 150 different VMs that were managing for our build process. These VMs were largely individualized per application. And so we couldn't really maintain them, we couldn't really scale them, and it was a really major headache to manage. And so that's what this architecture aims to solve.
What is the volume of application we are talking about here?
So depending on how you consider an application, we have between 20 to 25 or so that would be an actual application end user would use. However, we have thousands of repositories that support those. So those would be things like DLLs, packages, so on and so forth, that really help kind of bring everything to life.
I see. I want our users to understand the scale of this. What is the build volume here we are talking about?
Yeah, so previously we were doing maybe 10,000 builds a month. And with this new architecture, we've been able to scale up to between 20 and 25,000 builds per month that we're able to do. Again, at quite the cost savings.
That's great. Let's dive into the architecture. Can you walk us through a workflow here when an application build comes into this architecture? How does it go through the workflow? And then what is the end result?
Yeah, definitely. So when a build comes in, it comes in from our primary GitLab instance into one of these two runners, depending on the resources that it needs. Once the runner picks it up, the first thing it's going to do is it's going to run out to S3 and determine if there's any cache or artifacts that it can use in order to speed up this build. Once it gets that cache and artifact, it pulls it back in, and then it will create a job. And these jobs are simply Kubernetes pods. So the pod will go in, it will, like I said, get the cache, get the artifacts for helping to speed up the builds, do what it needs to do. That can be compilation, that can be security scanning, that can be a whole host of things. Once the job is finished, it will then upload itself back to S3 for caching and artifacting. It'll then also take anything that it needs to, pass it back up to the runner, which will then pass it back into our primary GitLab instance.
How I heard it is that the architectural decision that you made to use a cache here is super important. Can you zoom into that?
Yeah, definitely. So our cache here is actually incredibly important for us. What we saw is we saw a speed up between 50 and 60% for utilizing a cache. A lot of that is because we're able to get such a big pipe into our instances. So by having the cache within the same VPC and using an endpoint, we were able to speed up our caches and download massive artifacts, some of which are 40, 50 gigabytes in size. And so not having to recompile that gives us massive cost savings there as well.
Let's look at the data plane here. You explained about the control plane, how it pulls those components into the build process. I want to understand and zoom in into the data plane and how the runners work and how these build jobs take those tasks.
Yeah, so one of the key differentiations between the worker and the base is that this is dedicated. So because our base node group needs to be up and listening, that's why it's dedicated. However, our worker node group is allowed to scale. And this one is allowed to scale from zero to, I forget how many, but I think up to 50 different instances.
Right. Okay.
And these instances are very large. These are .16s, XL, as well as .metal. By utilizing spot instances here, we get a lot of cost savings, allowing us to use these big instances, giving us even faster build processes. And we scale across all of our subnets and all of our AZs to give us more availability into what spot instances Amazon has available.
Oh, so that's the reason you have multiple subnets here.
Exactly, yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about the productivity gain from your development team's point of view?
Yeah, so because these individual jobs are so much faster, 50 to 60% faster, we're able to see much improved developer productivity because they're not waiting for their builds. And with this, because we're allowed to scale so high, there's no queuing. It'll just reserve more instances as it needs it. So that way we're able to meet all of the demands of our business. And so if there is a big time where we need to get something out, we are not waiting for our builds. And we do not have the cost of having our developers sit there doing nothing.
Mike, thanks for diving deep into this architecture.